Okay. 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 Okay, Ma. Love you too, Ma. Goodbye.
Perfect for those times when your to-do list is running long and your time is running short. Try Curbside Express today and save big with slashed fees on pickup and delivery.
Preseason football shows our new team in action. Training and preparation are necessary to win. A great season takes a team effort. Call 1-800-ELK-OHIO. For a team of injury lawyers that are always prepared, Elk and Elk, proud partner of the Cleveland Browns.
Back. 7-0 Browns over the Bills from First Energy Stadium. 5:22 to go in the first. Of course, the Browns won their preseason opener last week, 20-10 at the Meadowlands. And then you've got the Eagles coming up next week, too. That's the big one. That's the full dress rehearsal. The starters will get the most action in the third preseason game. And then the Browns will close it out.
Okay, while it's recording,
turning the page to the regular season. So the Bills back against it now. First and 10 from the 3-yard line after a terrific special team play all around. McCarron with the give to McCoy, who makes a man miss and moves it up to the 8-yard line.
A great move that time in the end zone by LeSean McCoy. He just get just save the safety. And did you see the way he's holding that ball, Jay? Watch as he
come on, Cleveland Brown.
You see a running back carry the football like that, but he gets away with it somehow. But man, he's got some sweet feet.
Well, six-time Pro Bowler. That doesn't happen by accident. That gives the Bills a little bit of operating room. Second down and 4 now. Philadelphia Eagles, Tim, he made an already strong linebacking core even better.
He did. What a great addition in the offseason, getting Michael Kendricks, a Super Bowl champion and a proven player in this league, to come over and join this already strong linebacking crew, like you said, Jay, with Schobert and Collins and Kirksey, and now you got a rookie in Jannard Avery and Kendricks. This is a strong, very strong linebacking group.
So this Bills offense yet to pick up a first down, 3rd and 5 now. They're 0-2 on...
Come on, Cleveland Browns! Get him! Yes!
Jeremy Curley can't bring it in. And again, Tim, this Browns defense, which looked so good last week against the Giants, forces its 3rd straight 3-and-out.
So impressive. And I'll tell you who's having a game already is Calhoun. He's made a couple plays in pass coverage. He made a great play in the run game on the previous drive. He's making some. He's one of those guys that can put him anywhere on the field. You know, he can play a corner. He can play against nickel. He's already showing his worth here early in this football game.
Antonio Callaway will not be able to field that one. That one goes out of bounds, and the Browns will take over near midfield. When we come back, it's been all Cleveland. 7-0 Browns. 3:43 to go in the first.
Side. Hey, buddy, buddy. Side. Side. Hey, buddy, buddy. Hey, buddy, buddy. Sign. Hey, sign, sign, sign. Sign, buddy, buddy. Hey, hey, hey. Buddy, buddy, sign.
Frankie, relax. We don't need gimmicks for our customers. Know why? Because the deals are so good.
Are you kidding me, Mike? Of course they are.
Get your all-star service from Northeast Ohio's only 10-time Nissan Award of Excellence recipient, BigNissan.com.
Why do I drive a big Nissan car? Because the deals are so good.
How many kids' soccer games this weekend?
4, and 2 volleyball games.
Divide and conquer.
I need a clone.
KeyBank can make a modest contribution.
How?
Do you have a smartphone?
I have to.
KeyBank makes it easy to manage your money anytime, anywhere. Use your phone to deposit checks on the go, transfer money, pay bills, and more.
I can take my bank to the game.
Precisely. And now get $300 when you open a premium checking account and set up direct deposits.
Sweet!
Use the red key. Only at KeyBank.
In sports, every battle comes with a start time. But our battles don't begin with a coin flip, and they don't end when the whistle blows. Our opponents, wind, rain, time, and chance, are always present. We wage a battle against darkness, against powerlessness. We're fighting right now, a team of more than 9,000. And if you don't notice us, that means we're winning.
My 5-alarm chili mix game day is better. You may not know it, but FanDuel does too. For new players, there are beginner-only contests for the real prizes to help you learn the ropes. And since you pick a new team every week, you never sideline with injuries or draft busts. Play for as low as a dollar, or compete for a share of a million. Or start a private contest to play against your friends. FanDuel, it's the 5-alarm chili your daily fantasy game for the week.
Get free entry into the Sunday Million with over $1 million in cash prizes when you make your first deposit. Use promo code ROCKS.
Welcome back to Cleveland. 7-0 Browns early on. Dustin Fox, Bernie Kosar. Bernie, we talked a lot about the running game this week. A lot was made about how it was ineffective the first couple weeks in camp, but not tonight. Why do you think?
It's amazing what will happen when you have a little failure like we had last week in the game. Yeah, the offense did good. The passing game was fantastic. Pass protection was really good. Running game was an issue. Focused on it. Coaches yelled quite a bit about it during the week, and you could see the emphasis in the game was really paying off.
Well, off to a good start. Back to you, boys.
All right, guys. Thanks. Yeah, you could tell that Greg Williams was happy with his defense's performance against the Browns offense in their practice session this week as Duke turns the corner and picks up 5. But it was clearly a point of frustration for Todd Haley that they weren't able to move the ball on the ground. And I mentioned the 33 attempts, just 50 yards. They've already eclipsed their yards on the ground this week in 2 series that they had the entire game against the Giants.
It's been impressive. You know, obviously Todd Haley wanted to come out here and show some physicality in this offense. He knows he can throw the football with these weapons and these quarterbacks that he has. He's aware that they can get it down the field and push it, but he wants to see if this team can come out and blow people off the ball and run the football against someone, and these guys are proving they can do that.
Browns defense, 9 plays, 9 yards allowed, 3 straight 3-and-outs. It's been all Browns so far. As Cleveland now faces a 3rd-and-9 from midfield. Tyrod Taylor in the shotgun wants to throw. Has time. And misses the receiver there. Jarvis Landry looked like he had some space, but Tyrod Taylor could not connect, and that'll force a Browns punt.
Yeah, I think Tyrod got a little confused that time by the coverage. Buffalo dropped into a deep zone. He didn't see the underneath coverage. I think he saw it at the last second, and if he would try to throw the football on the line and get it in there to Landry, it probably would have been picked off by the corner falling underneath.
So Justin Vogel, the Browns' backup punter, trying to make this team, kicks it inside the 10, and that's going to be a penalty on Jeff Janis, who interfered with Curley as he was calling for a fair catch. So the Bills will get a little help on starting field position for this, their 4th drive. Still looking for that first down of the game, Tim.
Yeah, we're going to have to get a little more aggressive in their play calling right now. I'm trying to push it down the field against this Browns defense.
Fair catch interference. Number 15 for the kicking team. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
Well, we mentioned the penalties from a week ago, Tim. Something certainly they want to clean up. That's textbook interference. Curley clearly calling for the fair catch, and whether or not it was just too late for Janis to put on the brakes or what, that gives the Bills a little extra push here to start their 4th drive of the game. They had 141 yards in penalties a week ago. 13 penalties, 141 yards, and no one was happy about that. So McCarron still under center for the Bills. Hit as he throws. That will fall incomplete. putting all kinds of pressure on McCarron.
They're all over A.J. McCarron in this football game. And look at the get off Miles Garrett, get off of the off the line, just pushing the left tackle back right into McCarron and getting a big hit on the quarterback.
Garrett's going to change life for the Cleveland Browns defensively, Tim. He's a freak of nature physically and athletically. But if he can get a full healthy season under his belt, I think the NFL is he's going to be one of the premier pass rushers in this game for sure. Second and 10 now for the Bills. McCarron gives to McCoy, who's got some space on the right side. Nice pickup of 10 yards, and that's going to bring up a third down and short. Dustin?
Hey, guys, just to piggyback what you're talking about with Myles Garrett in the pass rush, as a former defensive back myself, Myles Garrett is my best friend. So I'm looking at Terrence Mitchell out here and Denzel Ward. These guys are chilling because they got a pass rush finally.
And it goes hand in hand. Greg Williams was telling us yesterday, look, if our corners can give just an extra half second to second of coverage, he mentioned that there were 28 plays last season in which Myles Garrett was a step and a half from getting another sack.
Right.
28 plays.
It just makes perfect sense. He just wants to make the quarterback hold the ball an extra second like he did right here. The coverage in the secondary is outstanding. Give those pass rushers an opportunity to get home.
Well, McCarron scurries out of bounds to the first down marker, but you can bet that's coming back. Flags all over in the backfield.
Number 62 offense. 10-yard penalty still. Third down.
And that is a hold on the Buffalo Bills, so that will bring up third and long. And, Tim, it was pretty obvious that there was a hold. The Browns were putting great pressure on, and they never got to him.
Yeah, they're getting a lot of pressure on A.J., and great coverage in the secondary as well. You see A.J. just...
Come on, Cleveland Browns!
The Browns are just pursuing and getting pressure on the quarterback.
Bernie?
You know, Tim, to play off of what you're saying, exactly right. I mean, you want to see Buffalo maybe be more aggressive in their play calling, but Cleveland's only rushing four people, playing a zone, seven guys behind it. Very tough to be a successful quarterback when you're getting killed like that when they're only rushing four.
Absolutely.
So third down and 12 now for McCarron.
Get him!
Quick throw outside, that's complete, but that is going to be short of a first down. Denzel
Fiddlesticks.
Quick over to make the tackle. And this Browns defense has yet to allow a Buffalo Bills first down. That is their fourth straight three and out.
They're so impressive. I'm impressed with their overall team speed. And look at this rookie Denzel Ward come up and make a play. He's so good and he's so physical. He's such a physical corner. You wouldn't think he would be. He's only 190 pounds, but he's not scared to come up and deliver a hit.
Jerome Peppers fields the punt and goes out of bounds, but there is a flag on the play. We'll check that out as the Browns get ready to take over on offense. Sean McDermott getting an explanation.
12 players on the field of the receiving team. Penalty is declined. First down, Cleveland.
So the Browns will take over. We talked yesterday with Hugh Jackson about how much we would see the starters. He said, for sure a quarter, depending on how things go. And I would guess that this would probably be the last drive for the first team. But who knows? He may decide to go with them into the second quarter. But it's good to be able to see the first team for more than two offensive series. Last week they were on the field full of eight plays.
I think so. You still want to evaluate some of these first team guys. And you know, you still want to see Tyron, this offense, get the passing game going. Now, they've established the run early on, and now I wouldn't be surprised if we see that hurry up that we saw against the Giants last week just to get Tyron and the receivers going.
They get the ball.
Tyron to Carlos Hyde out the flats. He is quickly hit and dropped by Micah Hyde.
Did the Buffalo turn the ball over?
A 2 or 3 yard loss. That will bring up second and long for the Browns. Yeah, we saw that they wanted to pound the ball on the ground because that was certainly something that was missing from last week. And they've done that. They've established that. You think that they would like to give Tyrod a chance to sling it around.
Come on, Cleveland Browns.
See if they'll get one more snap here before the quarter's end, and they will not. So the first quarter has come to a close. It's been all Cleveland Browns. Defense forcing three
yes!
outs. And the Browns offense taking its opening drive the length of the field. 7-0 Browns. We're back to the second quarter after this.
Drug Mart carries most of the medications your pet needs at super low prices, including generic pet medications for as little as $1.99 per month.
Discount Drug Mart, take you the run around.
Discount Drug Mart, take you the run around.
You'll find everything you need.
Todd Haley, the first-year offensive coordinator for these Cleveland Browns, is creative. He likes to mix the run and the pass, and he has his Cleveland Browns out in front of the Buffalo Bills 7-0 as we start the second quarter. And, Tim, it's been all Browns. Buffalo held to just 17 yards of offense. That Browns defense has been everywhere. Tyrod, time to throw. Over the middle.
Yes!
His man caught and complete a nice catch.
Bullseye.
Rashard Higgins, who is really... had not just a good camp, but two good preseason games now, Tim.
And Higgins looks great. He makes plays every time he's out on the field, and just a nice job here. Look at Tyrod work that pocket step up by that time, and then Higgins working across, coming underneath the defender where Tyrod can trust him with that throw.
And they're at the point now where they're buying more plays. This is the first team. They get first downs, they get more opportunities to get things done. Last week, Higgins, four catches, 66 yards against the Giants. This time, a quick give to Carlos Hyde. Another effective run for that Browns offense. Pickup of five. That'll bring up second and five. And Tim, as an offensive coordinator, Haley loves second and five. It opens the playbook wide open.
It opens the playbook, and you see the Browns get in a little bit of a hurry up offense here just to try to get this Bills defense on their heels. And here goes Carlos Hyde again.
A huge opening up the middle for Carlos Hyde, who continues to eat here at First Energy Stadium. Tim, I think you or I could have run through that hole.
Yeah, great job by the offensive line. They're opening up holes, and Carlos is running hard today. Look at him lower the shoulder and finish that run.
Davis finding out firsthand that Carlos Hyde can lay a hit.
And the last thing you want as a free safety is to see 230-pound Carlos Hyde with a full head of steam coming right at you.
We have an injured Buffalo Bill down on the field after that play.
Somebody down.
Kyle Williams down on the field as the Bills training staff attends to him. I think the story of the early going here has been a Browns run game that people were questioning after their 33 attempt 50-yard performance a week ago. But they certainly are starting to put some of those whispers to bed. We're going to take a timeout with the injured Bills. 7-0 Cleveland, 13:57 left in the second.
Tonight at Fridays, we feast, we eat, we drink, we laugh. Tonight, we feast. Two apps, two entrees, two desserts. $20 only at Fridays.
7-0 Browns. Minute and change gone from the second quarter. Tim, it's been the Carlos Hyde show.
It has been the offensive line show, too. I'll tell you, I've seen Petonio and Corbett and Hubbard, those guys are all making great blocks and opening up holes, and Carlos Hyde is running strong tonight, already up to 64 yards.
Bullseye!
Antonio Callaway flags down on the play.
Oh.
Seven, but sort out the flags.
What gives? What's the flag penalty?
Pass interference. Number 80 of the offense, 10-yard penalty, still first down.
Fiddlestick.
Jarvis Landry called for pass interference.
Pass interference.
At the top of your screen, Jarvis Landry. Take a look here. He just...
Oh.
I'm not exactly sure.
I don't know if it was a pick.
No.
Don't quite understand that, but nonetheless...
Just contact you on 5 yards.
Puts the Browns in a first and 20 situation. Tyrod the throw, steps up in the...
Throw the ball!
Deep, and overshoots...
Tyrod
Taylor just couldn't connect with Rashard Higgins, who...
Darn!
...had a little bit of daylight on the defensive back, but...
Yeah,
the overshoot...
Higgins had a step, but look at the pressure that Tyrod Taylor is under. It's hard to step up and make a long throw down the field, but you got a guy rolling at your knees, a guy going up high. It's impossible to deliver an accurate football down the field that way.
Bernie looks familiar.
Yeah, it's interesting to watch that. Tim can attest to tough throw for quarterbacks. Yeah, the receiver has a step on him.
Come on, Cleveland Brown.
Right at the post. If you lead him more to the sideline,
go down.
Across the field, gives you a better opportunity to make that completion.
Yeah, definitely, Bernie. It gives you an opportunity to throw it away from the defender and let the wide receiver separate when you throw it across the field like that.
Short pick up there by Duke Johnson. That'll bring up a third down and 18 for the Cleveland Browns. This offense has had some explosive plays, Tim. Three runs of over 18 yards, one pass of over 18. So they have the capability to pick up the first down. Taylor with some communication. Pumps and then gets rid of it to David Njoku.
Oh.
In the opener last week, that will get it down to the 31-yard line, and that's close enough for a field goal, and that allows us, Tim, to sort of talk about
fiddlestick
at kicker. Zane Gonzalez, the Lou Groza winner from 2 years ago, had an okay rookie season, 15 of 20, but they brought in Ross Martin, a local product, actually from Solon, Ohio, played at Walsh Jesuit and then college ball at Duke. He's in to try a 53-yard field goal. And that's what you want as a young kicker in camp, an opportunity to kick a long one.
Pass interference, number 81 offense, 10-yard penalty, still third down.
Fiddlesticks.
And with that, Martin will trot off the field. So the pass interference will give the Browns another shot.
Well, that time it was Rashard Higgins. They got Jarvis Landry previously, but I guess they're just calling receivers are down before the ball is caught, and it's happened to the Browns twice now.
Well, it gives Tyrod Taylor an opportunity to make a big play. Third down and a mile. Could be the last play of the night for Tyrod and the first team offense. The quick hit goes to Higgins, who's corralled and thrown out of bounds by that Bills defense. And that would be too far for a field goal try, so the Browns will punt it away.
Fiddlestick.
Ross Martin almost had a chance. Britton Colquitt on to punt. And it's going to hit and roll into the end zone. For the touchback, so the Bills will take over on offense when we come back. Cleveland over Buffalo 7-0.
Summer sales event with select SUVs starting around $20,000. This summer is going to be epic. Right now, you can lease a 2018 Tucson for only $139 a month. Visit buyhyundai.com.